To me, gang, the army, the navy, the unstoppable, man. Listen, listen, we back with some of that Clubhouse footage, yurt. We got your guy, Wack 100, man, talking crazy in the chat right now about the whole mob ties, Jay Prince Jr., Jazz, all that, man. He going in. He making a lot of sense, though. Like I said, man, I don't always agree with Wack, but when I agree with him, I agree with him. Some of this stuff, you know what I'm saying, is a little bit, you know, just him chatting. But I'm going to let y'all listen, man. I ain't going to waste too much time. But what he is talking about, basically, he chatting it up about mob ties not showing up to the funeral for Takeoff and their ulterior motives that they had. They knew they was going to get fired on if they showed up and all that. But I'm going to let him tell it to you himself, you know what I mean, and I'll be back with you.
Told y'all they wasn't going to show up. I said, them niggas ain't showing up to that shit.
That's crazy.
See, when you ain't did it, you pulling up with your squad. You letting niggas know, look, you're going to kill me. Whatever you going to do, do it. We ain't had nothing to do with that shit, homie. We ain't had nothing to do with that shit, bro. Hell yeah, I'm going to show up. Why wouldn't I show up? But when you got an inkling in the back of your mind of what that real reality is, that you not, they said Wack is a checkpoint down there, and I know I got a warrant. I'm not going down there. I ain't going. I know I got a warrant. Ain't no... I know as soon as they run me, nigga, what is coming back.
Real talk.
Straight up. I didn't have that shit happen. Like, niggas was putting this shit on niggas. Niggas showed up such, such outside. Blood, listen, homie, I ain't did that. Nigga, if y'all gonna do something to me, it wasn't me. I don't know who the fuck pumping that shit. Nigga, I wasn't here. I mean, a homie had an argument, but it wasn't that serious. Nigga, y'all gonna do something to me, but I'm finna go in there and pay my respects, homie. I ain't did that shit. Niggas is going to show up.
So you think they should have just showed up?
No, I know. Look, this, right? Look, we ain't proven one thing in the last couple of weeks is these niggas ain't smart as everybody make them to be. Y'all, well, we didn't move them. We didn't move them from this flow right here, have we not? We didn't came in there. I said, watch this. Go screenshot the shit. They unfollowed them. Y'all screenshot the timestamp. So soon we get to talking about it. Somebody, they going to get it back to them. 8 minutes later, they follow back.
Calling it play by play.
I'm telling them, I said, watch these bozos follow back because they see we see it. And this before the blogs even had it, right? So it's obvious we know that these niggas ain't the smartest motherfuckers in the world. You know what I'm saying? They not. Niggas is giving them too much credit, but there's only one reason you ain't showing.
Hey, can I ask you, how did he get that boogeyman title in hip-hop?
You got to ask them, bro. He ain't put in no work with us, my nigga.
Right.
That's he back then, man. They would have slapped the shit out that little nigga, man. Nigga wasn't playing no game.
No.
Nigga wasn't playing no game. What? Bro, niggas was not playing no games, bro. You talking about the era, nigga, of the Uzi and the birth of the AK and Killer Dayton's, nigga. And wasn't no nigga playing no games, bro. Wasn't no cameras. Niggas was knocking. We talking about when niggas got out in the middle of the intersection, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, nigga skirted out. Niggas wasn't playing no games, bro. We banging it out. Bro, we talking about niggas when niggas was on the roofs of the Nickersons gunning at the motherfucking ghetto bird, nigga, with choppers. That's when his start was. There wasn't nobody playing what? It was a real respect thing. Nigga. Even if it was your enemy, nigga respected you. It wasn't no nigga playing no game. They was leaving niggas on their porch, bro, with their nuts cut off, stuck in their mouth. Literally. This was the savage shit going on in that era, nigga. Literally.
Colombian bow tie?
Yeah, niggas wasn't playing no motherfucking games about none of that shit, bro. Nigga, wait, go look at them niggas in New York, the preacher crew. We talking about in every section niggas wasn't playing, bro.
Right. Yeah, it was different.
What is Zim in here? Man, go ask these New York niggas about the preacher crew, nigga. They might have a segment of them niggas up somewhere on Netflix or something.
Was snatching. It was a game?
Yeah,
preacher crew. Yeah, nigga, it was good. They wasn't playing no games, kidnapping niggas. They the ones snatched up Rich Porter's little brother. Yeah. Let me tell you what that nigga said in the courtroom when they sentenced him, nigga. They said, yo, you got any words or something for the family? That nigga told them niggas, look, man, y'all can suck a AIDS, a fat dick with AIDS, and all I want to know is did the motherfucking New York Yankees win the motherfucking World Series, nigga? Other than that, you.
Damn.
The mentality was savage.
These are the
niggas that trained us. Right. Hey, go. Kill or be killed. Go. Nigga, that's it. Either you is you or them. Like, go. Like, you got the Armenians putting in work. Russians putting in work. The Asians. Niggas be underestimating them Asians. Nigga. Them Asians was a problem because they had all the artillery. right?
Right.
Then you had the real, that real root of that Crip and Blood shit. Then you had, you go down there, nigga, to Philly, right? What was them niggas? The Black Mafia? Mafia niggas down there?
JBM.
K Front. Yeah. Zulu Nation up top. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Hey, you had, bro, you go to Chicago, bro, that's when that, I see these youngsters now. But that real vicious shit, that Valentine's Day Massacre style shit was really going on up there, bro.
Boy, on my block saying. In the like, 90s.
Now you got to think about it. You never hear of dude having any of them type of movement.
Never. That's what I'm saying.
So who he gave him, always who gave good. Him the title?
Who gave him mob ties? Who gave him that? They did.
Right.
And then everybody just started going, oh, Drake. He invited Drake, Meek Mills, and 10 other rappers, Rick Ross. They took a picture at a table all saying, mob ties. These is rappers, the whole industry bit. Ain't now one of these niggas did 8 days collectively in jail.
God damn. God damn.
Yeah, this real talk. So they do that. They mob ties. I'm going to tell you something. That nigga Finesse 2 times. Let J. Prince Jr. get out of line and watch. He going to slap the shit out that nigga. He already see the bitch in him. Let that Finesse the real gutter nigga. Let Jr. get out of line with it and watch what he do. Because guess what? Memphis can fight they click in Houston all day. All he got to do is go back to his roots. See, Nashville couldn't fight New York. That's why Young Buck couldn't stand a chance. Cali could fight New York. That's why Game action and winning.
Right.
Right now today, how it stands, Memphis can fight Houston. Because all of Houston gonna say we don't fight with that nigga. That's on y'all. So he'll just be fighting him. Watch. Soon as dude get out of line with Finesse, Bermar called it. He gonna slap the shit out of that nigga and click it off. He ain't that kind of
nigga. He just not.
Gave himself a title.
He gave himself a title. And now it's looking crazy. You notice you ain't been hearing nothing about no nigga screaming on mob ties. Mob ties supposed to keep a nigga safe, keep a nigga straight, all this type of shit. Unless you saying mob ties on the side of we lined the nigga up. Is that what you mean?
What about the rappers that went against you, Wack, when you was going back and forth with Jay Prince? What about the rappers?
Those
that
are, look, no, bro, it's the where popularity they at? Where they vote. At? See, look, it's the popularity vote. This is the thing with me. I'm a real life renegade loner, nigga. So I don't give a fuck about all the shit, right? What's with me, what ain't. You know what I'm saying? That's the popularity vote. Okay, everybody is flocking to this. But ain't none of them niggas gonna die about it. I run into them niggas one by one. You know what they say? What up, Unc? What up, OG? That nigga called Kanye 100 times. Kanye, we supposed to be this. You see, Kanye go right on drink chest and say, Wack 100's my friend. That's my friend. He called the nigga 100 times. Stop talking to him. Stop this. Stop that. Stop this. Stop. Because Kanye understands you who you are. He who he is. My relationship with you is here. That's what it is. And that's it. And you might turn on me one day. Nigga. So what the f***? You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's the popularity, bro. A lot of them is French Montana. That's my partner. Y'all watched me in Passion Room about 2 months ago. It's a security nigga. Get out of line with his mouth. I said, you French bodyguard? Watch this. The nigga phone lit up. The nigga hit Passion. The nigga just called French. I can't say nothing, another word to him, Passion. I'm on mute. But he hit the mob ties table too.
All right, man. So as you can see, Wack 100 going in, man. He got a lot to say. He got a lot to say. And y'all already know I'm here to bring it to you. I'm going to bring you the info as it comes out, man. Wack 100 be saying some real shit sometimes, man. A lot of other times, though, he do be saying some nut shit. So, you know what I mean? You got to take it at face value. You know what I mean? It is what it is. It's Wack 100 talking.